pushing my buttons, this ain't no game to me. Yeah, ain't got time to be explaining me. Yeah, I'ma just take over the game, baby. Yeah, let me show you how to be a star. Let me show you how to go far, far. Let me show you how to shine bright.
Southern California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place, wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Los Angeles Chargers. 2 weeks have come and gone. It's off to week three, and we're underway on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Started on the ground with Eckler. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
A nice run here early on. It didn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. Now it's Herbert. And this one incomplete, threw it down at the feet of his receiver.
Well, anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
Two plays in, this is third and 2. Here's Herbert. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test him early. But it proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
On is the punter, Scott, here as he gets this one away. A 40-yard punt, give him 3 on the return, and the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up, first and 10 at their own 26. Now the Chargers are going to look up here and signal for a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. This is James Robinson. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. He'll lose a yard. Second and 11. First carry for the Clemson man, Travis Etienne.
And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. No gain that time, and it leaves him with third and 11 coming up. An extra quarterback now in the game for the Chargers here on third.
They go play action with Lawrence. And the pass is intercepted. He was looking for Ingram. It's Chris Harris with a pick. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training. So he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positive moving forward.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
First play, the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. That's complete to the tight end, Akins. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a third and 7. Play action, it's Herbert. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. They overload him that time with a safety blitz, and he winds up being dropped for a loss of 7. Hopkins' kick is good, and the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. So the interception set him up in terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points. But that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Their second drive here, the ballgame, Charles. Remember last time they threw the interception, but the defense held up. It bent a little but didn't break, only giving up the 3 points.
Yeah, obviously they left some points on the table there their last time out, but boy, they have to thank their defense for holding the opposition.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by J.C. Jackson.
I think this is where long-term starters in the NFL separate themselves from the rest of the pack, because there's still 3 full quarters left in this one. More than enough time to move past a pair of early mistakes and find a way to lead your team to a win. Mental resiliency, a characteristic every NFL team's looking for in their quarterback.
A beautiful fake. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 16 yards is the pickup there, and a first down for L.A. The city a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
First down, Justin Herbert. He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. Touchdown! Gerald Everett, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Hopkins with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away.
fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
For this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back, but make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
I'm not quite sure what he thought he saw there, but the reality was certainly a much different picture than what he anticipated. And give credit to the defense. They were down on the flash when he broke out of there, and they forced him out with almost nothing to show for his efforts.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
Well, you've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
It's a return of five following a punt of 42 yards, and it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going. They're looking sharp, out early to a 10-zip lead and looking for more as they've got it first and 10. Here's Eckler to begin the drive. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. All around great play by Devin Lloyd, using his athleticism to get to the backfield and his strength to stop him for a loss.
At the 26-yard line.
The score after one on EA Sports. Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ballgame as they come up first and 10. And he'll throw this one away. I don't think he's out of the pocket. No, here comes the flag.
Yeah, he hadn't gotten far enough away from the pocket to throw that football away, and that draws the flag.
Yeah, the old tackle box, right? Get outside of each tackle, and then you can go ahead and throw it away, and you're in good shape. But if you're back there in the pocket, you got to make sure of what you're doing.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. And strong running there gets us up over the 15-yard line. That'll net 7 yards on the ground, but it'll leave him with a healthy distance still to go on third down.
play action. It's Lawrence.
But he's got the hookup here to DeSean Jackson. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. Third and 19, no problem as they're able to convert.
On play action, Lawrence. He'll get this off to ETN.
And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. Four catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
Off the play fake, here's Lawrence.
This one complete to Christian Kirk. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 38-yard line. 17 yards on the play as they try to eat into this 17-point deficit. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
They go play action now. Lawrence.
Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack.
Now Lawrence.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, this defense is certainly organized and playing off of each other because the rush is providing pressure and the coverage is forcing incompletions and capitalizing on mistakes. When you get every level on defense hitting at once, you get first half scores just like this one.
The Jaguars on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 15.
Now Lawrence to throw.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side.
And that's the third interception for Lawrence.
Picked up by J.C. Jackson.
And the Chargers are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line.
Partner, have you ever heard the story of Icarus in mythology? That's the guy who flew too close to the sun and had his wings melted. That was our guy right there. Keeps pressing it and pressing it. Finally, on that throw, he paid the price with that turnover.
The Charger drive about to get going.
They got the ball now following a big play, keeping the other guys out of the end zone. Now they'll start deep in their own territory, first and 10.
And they'll hit him for a loss as he's back to his 2-yard line. Now they had stopped him for a loss on the run anyway, so they'll decline that.
It's almost a good psychological advantage, isn't it? You created a penalty, and you still couldn't gain yards against us. No way we need to take that one.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play.
He'll get this out wide to Eckler.
And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So with the completed pass and the yardage they got, they'll decline the penalty.
So obviously, more yards on the pass completion than they would have gained with the penalty. They did the math. They did it well, and it works for them.
This is a counter play. Eckler. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. 2 minutes remaining in this first half for football. First down now. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
Back in 60.
Herbert off of play action. Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Rayshon Jenkins picks it off. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Boy, a big play right there. I mean, a touchdown on this drive could have really put some separation on the scoreboard. Instead, it's the defense who scores. And, partner, we got a game again.
And we do have one because of what you just described, a defense that understood what was going on in this game and did something about it. They knew their offense needed some help. They just provided it. They're back in this one.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Charger drive about to get going. Running on first down, Eckler. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. With it, looking to pass. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Foyasane Anuluka. And to the 43. So down inside the 35 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over.
And that now two interceptions thrown in the second quarter.
And you know, a lot of people look at these guys and they think to themselves that maybe, possibly, they're still thinking about the first one. And they probably are. I think in this case, he's just trying to atone for the first interception. Tried a little bit too hard, maybe forced it a bit, and instead created a second one.
The first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Lawrence will throw. He'll drop this one off with ETN. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And that'll force upon him a third and 14. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on third down. Here's Lawrence. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Engram. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15.
First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. Give him a gain of five on the completion, and that's going to bring up second down. Brings up seven and
five. Throwing again here, it's Lawrence.
And this one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football, nearly a fourth pick of the ball game.
This defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. Now Lawrence. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Now Lawrence on first down. He'll buy some time right. Got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Evan Engram in 11. 7-yard touchdown.
And the Jaguars get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point by Patterson, up and good.
And the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going.
And they may just be content to take this three-point lead and head into the locker room.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground.
And obviously not fooling anybody here as they stop him behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
2 yard loss brings up third down and 12.
So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Jaguars with work to do. They trail here as we are back underway on EA Sports.
Entering settings screen, you have 20 options. Menu narration option is set to off is selected.
We saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence.
And he wisely will throw that one away.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
Lawrence
finds his tight end Ingram, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus, and indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down.
Lawrence going to throw again. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. It's his guy on the flat.
And so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about, in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice safe throw and a good one.
Escaping the pressure right. And able to find Kirk complete.
And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
On first and 10, it's ETN.
And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Muffed that down for a win in the defense's column.
Flushed out right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up. And they need 9 yards on third down.
Looking to throw, Lawrence. He'll get that underneath ETN.
Yeah, this defense rallies, and they stop him short of the first down right near the 24. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a fourth down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Riley Patterson now on for the field goal.
And this one, a 41-yard attempt.
Patterson's kick is good.
And that will tie things at 17-all. So they come away from this opening drive of the third quarter with only 3, but it does draw them even.
Yeah, that has to be job one, doesn't it? A touchdown definitely would have been nice. We know that. But here, you get back on even terms, and now you've got most of the second half to try and get yourself into a position to win.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Charger drive about to get going. And their 3-point halftime lead gone now, back to a tie game. But, Charles, I don't imagine that changes too much for this offense.
I would agree. I don't think it changes much at all, whether it's a 3-point lead or a tie game. They know they have their work cut out for them, and they were going to run their offense in the same vein.
43 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
One play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Once more, here's Eckler.
And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Now it's Herbert. And that's complete to the right side. It's Allen.
And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or...
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
A good chance. This is 4-down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a 3rd and 3. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 29-yard line. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
They'll give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
On first down, it's Herbert. Throwing the out route, and he's got Eckler. And down inside the 15 he goes. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Three quarters have come and gone. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The 13 now, they work on first and 10. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Austin Eckler. His first rushing touchdown of the year. And the Chargers have broken this deadlock and have taken the lead here in the fourth. Hopkins with the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They now trail by 7 after that last touchdown here in the fourth quarter. What a big spot for this offense. See if they can cobble something together on this drive. They'll start on the ground. ETN. He works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there. Second down.
Well, you don't turn your nose up at a gain of 4, do you? They'll take that on first down. Playbook's got to be pretty well open on 2nd and 6.
29-yard line.
Got it.
2nd and 6, just inside the 30. Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. He'll air this one out for Kirk. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Now the Jags will use the 2nd of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this fourth quarter. Will be 3rd and 6. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That's a 3rd down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
On 1st and 10, it's Lawrence. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and 1 yard.
I think the defense surprised him there with that blitz on 1st down, but give him credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll run with ETN. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a 1st down. Move the chains, a gain of 7 on 3rd down.
Brandon, unfortunately, I've been here before. They've had 2 opportunities to stop them, so this is demoralizing. They haven't gotten it done. Now you're calling all your blitzes, all your attack defenses, but you're not worried about playing your normal position. You're going to take chances now.
Well, you said it. Two third down opportunities to get off the field. Couldn't do it, and the clock continues to roll. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. From the 29, Lawrence. And that's complete ETN out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line. On third down, here's ETN. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. Here we go. Gotta have it. Lawrence. This is caught. It's Kirk. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. A quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
It's not the first time they've gone his way on this drive, and they were obviously keyed into it because they were there to help break that pass up.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Now Lawrence to throw. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. On that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. A snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And he'll take this one down inside the 5 to the 3. They'll try and throw for it with Lawrence. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Christian Kirk from 3 yards out. And the Jaguars are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes. They get one more as the extra point's up and good. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. Charger drive about to get going. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. Herbert gonna throw. He's got Eckler. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Out of the gun, Eckler running it. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Now Herbert. He finds his target, Allen. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 36. They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7.
Herbert to throw. He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 13-yard line. Now the timeout will be called, so they're in field goal range with 3 seconds left. So now it all comes down to Dustin Hopkins, and a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. With 3 seconds to go, this for the win. And his kick is good. And this home crowd is in a frenzy as their guys have pulled it out of the end.
Well, Carter, you and I were excited for this one today and certainly had its moments. Some good execution at times by both of these offenses. Defenses both made some plays as well. And always a joy to be up here in the booth next to you, my friend.
Yeah, it's a privilege to be up here in the booth next to you as well. Thanks for taking the time. And let's go ahead and get ready for our next one, right? I'll see you in the film room. Get that preparation started now.
So for the Chargers, they're into the win column now as they move to 1-2 on the young season.
Star, they hear my name and remember me.